In our immune system, many cells play a part, among which white blood cells. An important white blood cell is the macrophage. The macrophage recognizes the bacterium as a non-self substance and engulfs it. The bacterium is slowly destroyed in the macrophage until only very small pieces are left. These little pieces of bacterium are made visible on the outside by the macrophage. This way, the other cells of the immune system are able to notice that a bacterium has entered the body. Apart from that, something else is happening. Since the macrophage engulfs the bacterium, it creates inflammatory substances. These substances are called cytokines. Cytokines bind themselves to receptors on cells. Cytokines exactly fit the shape of such a receptor, like a key in a keyhole. In this manner, the cytokine communicates to another cell. For example, a cytokine is able to warn a macrophage from the position of another macrophage that bacteria are near that have to be destroyed. This is an important step in the inflammatory response. At the point of the inflammation, the amount of macrophages then increases in order to destroy the bacteria. The macrophages are, however, not able to destroy all bacteria. The macrophages, therefore, go to the lymph nodes in our body in order to warn other cells of the immune system that an inflammatory response is taking place. These lymph nodes are important with regard to the defense of the body. Lymph nodes are information centers where cells of the immune system meet in order to exchange information. The macrophages that have engulfed bacteria at the point of the inflammation come into contact with T cells in the lymph nodes. B cells are also present there. Both are white blood cells that play an important part in the inflammatory process. T cells recognize the bacterium pieces on the outside of the macrophage. The T cells bind themselves to those pieces of bacterium on the macrophage, and they become active. The B cells also become active. After this activation, the T cells and B cells divide until a large quantity of these cells has come into being. The T cells and B cells go to the spot of the inflammation. At the spot of the inflammation, the T cells help the other inflammatory cells to attack the bacteria as effectively as possible. This way, they help the macrophages to make more cytokines, which are the inflammatory substances, and they attack bacteria in order to destroy them. As soon as all bacteria have been destroyed, the inflammatory response ceases.